This is setup of the TP-Link Tapo Pan Tilt camera. First things first, you're going to make sure that you download the Tapo app from TP-Link, which is different than the Casa app. However, the Casa app login information will work with the TP-Link Tapo since it is the same company. If you already have a device installed on your application, you'll see it right there, but we need to install a new one. So we're gonna come up to the upper right-hand corner here, press the plus sign with the circle, and then look for our camera. We're gonna select that, and next we have to plug it in. So we're gonna take our power cable, which I have off camera and already plugged in. We're gonna drop it right there, and we have this set up so that the lens is facing forward so that we can see the light right there. And we're just gonna let it sit there and wait for it to blink. It says it can take up to 30 seconds to actually do. So just be mindful of that and be patient as it situates itself. And there we go. It's blinking. We will select next, and it wants to turn on location. We're going to enable. In my case, I'm only going to do it this time for the setup. And there we can see it's kind of spinning around, and we're gonna wait for it to come back. And now we can see it is turning red and green as it finishes its 360 motor check. We'll wait for it to finish, come back to center. Oh, that's doing all sorts of checking here. All right, so it's choosing to be in its actual position. We're going to select next because it did everything that it needed to do. We're going to connect to the Wi-Fi network that this is creating so that they can talk to each other. So in my case, I've done this once before. My phone does not particularly care for the fact that this is a Wi-Fi network that does not allow you to access the internet. So it kind of prevents me from accessing it. You'll notice right up here, it says LTE. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to pop into my Wi-Fi networks, find the one right here for this. And then we're gonna wait and make sure that when I connect to it, I get a warning. It says, does not provide internet. And there we go, I get a warning right here. I click on this and then I say, yes, it's fine. And then we're gonna try again. So next, and there I can see, I know it's connected to it, has an exclamation point letting me know that there's no actual internet access with this particular Wi-Fi network that I've joined. And there we go. Also, since I set this up before, it already knows what network I want to put it on, as well as the password, since I saved it from last time. Still don't like the fact that it shows you in plain text the actual network credentials. Wish that wouldn't do that. After that, it will connect to our network and we should hear the camera actually say connecting. And there we go. Maybe you missed it. It said connecting to Wi-Fi.
Wi-Fi connected.
Wi-Fi connected if you didn't hear it. And a ding to let us know it's done. I got an AlexA notification letting me know that this was attached to it since I've already set up the integration for AlexA and it. Now, this is the one thing that I don't like with the setup process. Even though it's connected, this screen just kind of keeps going and it's done. We don't have to sit through this. So if we come up here and select the X, yes, we're gonna exit, but right there, we can see our new Tapo camera. And if we select that, welcome to, we're gonna go, kind of letting you know what you can do with it, and then select got it, and we're gonna shift that right over there so that we do not see me in frame, but we're gonna give that a moment, and there we go, it is connected. All right, so that was the setup of the TP-Link Tapo Pan Tilt indoor camera.